Hey everybody, it's Ron from Pick Dawgz, and this is Ron's Bank Shot Breakdown. We're going to go over five college basketball games for Saturday, December 9th, 2023. Now, if you like what you see, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to put your college basketball picks in the comment section below. And if you're looking for my best bets, including my $19 Bank Shot best bet, as well as my all-access season pass at College Hoops, you can find those at the premium picks tab at pickdawgz.com. Alrighty, let's get into it. Here's Saturday's games in college basketball. First up, we see Grand Canyon and Liberty, two of the best teams in mid-major college basketball this year. This one's going to be 2 p.m. Eastern. It's going to be on ESPNU. Now, Grand Canyon 7-1 this season. Liberty 7-2, two teams ranked inside the top 100 in KenPom. But Grand Canyon, and we talked a lot about how they have a really good home court advantage. We saw that in the game against San Diego State, where the Antelopes won that game outright 79-73. However, on the road, I'm not in love with this team against some tougher teams like Liberty. You know, Grand Canyon only had one true road game this season. That was against UT Rio Grande Valley. They won that game, Grand Canyon did, but they failed to cover the number. It was a 10-point win, and they were laying around 13.5 points. So I'm not in love with this spot for them, you know, in a really tough place to play. Liberty also has a really nice home court advantage. And, you know, Liberty's lost two of its last three games, but those teams, pretty solid teams. Charleston and FAU, of course, the Owls, one of the best teams in college basketball this year and last year. I think Liberty's the better team here slightly, but I do think that the home court advantage really helps them in this ball game. Liberty's such a good shooting team, 16th in the country in effective field goal percentage, great three-point shooting numbers, but also top 15 in two-point field goal percentage. Grand Canyon struggling to defend the perimeter this season, ranked 276th in three-point defense. I think Liberty takes advantage of that. I think Liberty's defense is also underrated right now. Give me the Flames in this one. I'll lay the points with Liberty at home. Next up, we see Richmond and Florida. This one's going to be a 4 p.m. Eastern start time. It's going to be on the SEC Network, and it's going to be a part of the Orange Bowl Classic, so a neutral site game in Sunrise, Florida. Now, last year, the Florida Gators were 146th in average possession length offensively, right around the nation average in possession length, probably you could say a bit faster than most teams in college hoops. But this season, Florida, 11th in the country in average possession length offensively, one of the fastest teams in college hoops. They're 23rd in adjusted offensive efficiency. They're a pretty good shooting team, but more than that, they get to the free throw line, and they're one of the best offensive rebounding teams in college basketball. I think that that pace of play and also the rebounding numbers could be a problem for Richmond. I think it's going to put them in an uncomfortable spot. You know, Richmond runs that Princeton-style offense, which slows the game down quite a bit under Chris Mooney, and you know, a lot of passes for this team. They don't turn the ball over too much, a lot of cutting. But they also not a very good offensive rebounding team. They don't get to the free throw line much. And I think the Florida Gators' pace of play on the other side of the court could put Richmond in a few tough spots early in this game and even late in this game if Richmond runs out of gas. I think Florida is the much more talented team in this ballgame. I think their defense is underrated. Yes, it's been giving up a lot of points per game, but the efficiency is still pretty solid because of the pace that Florida plays at. Naturally, they're going to give up a lot of possessions and, you know, a lot of points to their opponents. But against Richmond, I just don't think Richmond keeps up for a full 40 minutes. I like Florida in this game laying the points at the neutral site. Next up, we see one of the bigger rivalries in non-conference college basketball. It's Cincinnati and Xavier. This one's going to be a 6:30 Eastern start time. It's going to be on Fox Sports 1. And Cincinnati, 7-0 this season. Perfect record. One of the best records, obviously, in college basketball. They're 27th in KenPom to start the year. However, they've only played one true road game, and in that true road game, they played Howard, a team that's ranked 215th in the ratings, and they went to overtime in that game. They only beat Howard by 5 points, 86-81. Failing to cover the number in the end. And overall, Cincinnati's played a pretty weak schedule. This is actually their first top 100 team that they played this year, and it's in a really tough environment. Xavier has a really nice home court advantage, especially in this rivalry. Now, Xavier's been a really weird team this season. We knew they lost a lot of production from last year's team. They lost a couple players for the season due to injury, and it was kind of, you know, up in the air what we were going to see from Xavier. They started the season with two wins against some weaker opponents. They actually played pretty well against Purdue. They covered the number in the end, 83-71. They lost that game, but they covered the number. They lost to Washington. You know, that was a close game there, 74-71. They beat St. Mary's. Pretty nice win on the resume. But in the last three games now for Xavier, they took upset losses to Oakland and Delaware, which not a lot of people saw coming, but they also competed down the stretch against Houston, one of the best teams in the country. They covered the number in a 66-60 final score. So really inconsistent efforts from Xavier this year. But what we've seen, when they play these tougher teams, these top 100 teams, they've competed. They covered the number against Purdue. They beat St. Mary's outright in a blowout. They covered the number against Houston. They lost to Washington, but they're 3-1 against the number in those games against top 100 teams. And I think they, you know, at home here with Cincinnati not really playing a much, you know, very tough schedule, I think Xavier competes in this one as well. Xavier, a very good defensive team, 35th in the country in adjusted defensive efficiency. Now, offensively, this team takes a lot of tough shots. That's why I don't love them in terms of a long-term aspect. They take a lot of, you know, mid-range jumpers, some fadeaway jumpers. But Cincinnati's two-point defense is beatable. It's only 131st in the country in two-point defense. So I think Xavier actually scores some buckets in this game, especially at the rim if they can get there. I like Xavier in this matchup to earn the W against their rival. Cincinnati just hasn't been tested enough for me to take a chance with them on the road. Next up, we see UCLA and Villanova. This one's going to be 7 p.m. Eastern. It's going to be on Fox. Now, Villanova's lost three straight games now to St. Joseph's, Drexel, and Kansas State. Two upset losses, and then a close game in overtime at Kansas State, 72-71. I do think Villanova still is the better team in this matchup, though. I mean, Villanova has had a really tough schedule this year. They played Maryland, Texas Tech, North Carolina, and Memphis. Three of those games at neutral sites. They won all those games, by the way. Those most recent losses aren't great, but this is still a team that's top 50 in both adjusted offensive and defensive efficiency. They're a very good fundamental team. They take care of the basketball. They're very good on the defensive glass. They get to the free throw line, and they're number one in the country in free throw shooting. UCLA has a couple of games and step-up games against Marquette and Gonzaga. Both of those were losses. They lost by two and they lost by four. So they were competitive games, but two losses nonetheless. Outside of that, they haven't really been challenged. They played three teams to start the season at home that were ranked outside the top 300 in KenPom. They played a subdivision opponent, and then they played UC Riverside in their most recent game. By the way, that was a one-point victory, 66-65 against Riverside at home. Not what you want to see if you're UCLA. Now in a true road game and a tough place to play in Villanova, I think Villanova is the much better team here, and I think we're getting a really good price with them because of their recent losses, those upset losses, you know, the bad losses to St. Joe's and to Drexel, even though those teams are much improved this year and those are big rivalries. I think Villanova takes care of business in this one, gets a big win on the resume. Give me Villanova. I'll lay the points. And the final game we're going to talk about for Saturday's card in college basketball, it's the final game of the card in general, the 11 o'clock start time between Gonzaga and Washington on ESPN2. Gonzaga, number 7 in the country this year. They only have one loss on the season. That was against Purdue, one of the best teams in the country. It was a 10-point loss at the neutral site. And they played a few neutral site games, four neutral site games to be exact for Gonzaga, but no true road games. We've faded a few teams now this year that have played in their first true road games, you know, five, six, seven games through the season, and they haven't fared too well, especially in tough environments like Washington. This is a solid Washington team, a team I think is flying under the radar, and a team to watch out for in the Pac-12 when we get to conference play. Washington doesn't have a ton of great wins on the resume so far this year. They do have that nice win against Xavier at the neutral site, 74-71. Hasn't been the most challenging schedule for the Huskies, but this is a team that's much improved offensively. They're getting really good shots offensively. They're making their shots, you know, unlike last year where they were ranked 263rd in effective field goal percentage. This year, Washington 74th in the country in effective field goal percentage. Really good two-point shooting numbers. They're taking care of the basketball. They're a really good offensive rebounding team. Their defense, while, you know, the shot quality may not be the best, there's still a defense that's ranked 36th in effective field goal percentage defense. They're defending the perimeter really well, which is important against Gonzaga. And I think that Washington's a live dog in this ball game. This is a huge game for this program. You know, they don't get to host teams like Gonzaga very often in non-conference play. And, you know, for Mike Hopkins, this could be a program-boosting W, not just for this season, but, you know, in the next few years in terms of recruiting. This is a huge game against a top 10 opponent. And I think Washington, when you look at the numbers, when you look at these two teams, they match up pretty well, Gonzaga. And I'm going to take those points with the Huskies in this game. I think they certainly could win this game outright, but take the points just in case.
And that's it. Those are the games for Saturday in college basketball. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. And don't forget to put your college basketball picks in the comment section below. Again, if you're looking for my best bets, you can find those at Pick Dawgz Premium. As always, this is Ron Romanelli. Good luck.